Good afternoon. Can I remind members of the COVID-related measures that are in place and that face coverings should be worn when moving around the Chamber and across the Holyrood campus? The first item of business this afternoon is time for reflection. And our time for reflection leader today is Reverend John Murdoch, Minister, St John's Kirk of Perth and St Leonard's in the Fields, Perth.
Presiding Officer, members of the Scottish Parliament, a very good afternoon to you all. It is an honour to be with you. I send from my congregations every good wish for what you do for our country. We pray for peace. We live in very tense times, none more so than during this abominable situation in Ukraine. Each day last week, St John's here in Perth was open for public and private prayer for Ukraine. We remember you and all who lead us at Holyrood and Westminster in our prayers, together with Her Majesty the Queen, every Sunday. At this time of international tension, the hearts and minds of many incline to the wisdom of those who in past days, in other scenarios, have spoken to the soul. Reading recently the 272 words of President Lincoln in his two-minute Gettysburg Address on the 19th of November, 1863, I was in awe. How much we need to hear him again. His address concluded with, "Under God, government of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth." Government, of course, is there to lead us in the best ways. One of Lincoln's successors, Franklin Roosevelt, when he talked of four essential freedoms, could be speaking to every man and woman in any century about our collective wish to live in those best ways, living in a world of peace and freedom, the fruit of best leadership, indeed, best fruit of leadership. In a different context, the same was expressed by Pope Benedict in his 2010 visit to the United Kingdom, remarking to trainee teachers in Twickenham, "What sort of world do you want to live in, and what sort of person do you wish to be?" Perhaps Benedict was echoing Roosevelt's four freedoms, freedom of speech and expression, freedom of every person to worship God in his, her own way, freedom from want, freedom from fear. My prayer and hope is that under God, we too can strive for those freedoms, continuing to look beyond our shores, especially to the needs of those far less fortunate, and that in our own country, we look to the solid ground of faith, hope, and love. May you who lead us be encouraged to keep on keeping on. Thank you in this Olympic year for taking the torch of the leadership baton forwards. But first and foremost, let us continue to hold the Ukrainian people in our hearts. Thank you so very much for inviting me to be with you. May God bless you all.
Thank you, Reverend Murdoch.